गाइस, गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन. वेलकम बैक टू द ऑनलाइन क्लासेस. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी अ न्यू चैप्टर व्हिच इज अगेन फ्रॉम योर हनीसकल बुक. वी विल सी द टॉपिक इज फेयर प्ले. ओके, वेयर वी आर गोइंग टू सी सम ऑफ द हाइलाइट्स ऑफ दिस चैप्टर. दैट आई जस्ट वॉन्ट टू आस्क यू, हैज योर बेस्ट फ्रेंड एवर डन समथिंग यू थॉट वॉज रॉन्ग? मीन्स हैव यू फ्रेंड डन समथिंग रॉन्ग विच वॉज मीन्स वॉट यू हैव थॉट वॉज रॉन्ग? वॉट डिड यू डू देन? मीन्स वॉट यू हैव डन आफ्टर नोइंग दैट? डिड यू कीप क्वाइट और डिड यू टेल योर फ्रेंड वॉट यू थॉट? मीन्स समथिंग वॉट यू हैव थॉट अबाउट लाइक रॉन्ग और समथिंग एल्स, हैव यू एवर टोल्ड दिस टू योर फ्रेंड ऑल्सो? Have you ever? When something your friend has told that you seemed that it is wrong, I won't do. Have you ever told this to your friend that you should not do these things, you should not do like so? Have you ever? Or you stayed quiet? No, he is my friend, I'm not going to inform you anything because he will get hurt, he or she will get hurt. So what you have done? So this is a story which is about true friend, okay? Who had to decide what was more important, friendship and enmity or a sense of what is right and what is wrong? Means here two friends are there which gets into a dilemma whether to go with the friendship or to give a fair answer or fair decision which was right or wrong. Okay, so let's see. We'll see and we'll learn a very important thing, important about friendship and the important about right and wrong, the truth and the false things. Okay, let's see. The chapter name itself, A Fair Play. You know about the sportsman, like a sportsman spirit. It means that however, means whatever you do, something wrong, or if you think something wrong about in an athlete, you can't be like giving your partner alcohol or something and you're running and he will come second and you will get first. It's not the sportsman spirit. Sportsman spirit means where you just belong. You have to stay truth. You have to stand with the truth. That if you failed in something, if you failed by a second also, by a minute also, you can't give excuses for that. You have to be there to bear whatever the consequences comes. Okay, so fair play, or we can say sportsman spirit. So part one we'll see, part second we'll see, and part third we'll see by part. First, two friends' name was Zumman Sheikh and Algo Chaudhary were good friends. So strong was their bond of friendship that when either of them went away from the village, the other looked after his family. Means whenever one of the friend were had gone out of the village, the other one will stay, will look after his family. Okay. Both were greatly respected in the village. Both were respected means they were respected greatly by others too, because they have the true bond of friendship. Whenever one was not there present in the village, the other one could look after his family. Zumman had an old aunt who had some property. This she transferred to him on the understanding that she would stay with him and he would look after her. What happened? Zumman had an old auntie and she had a property. She thought that she will give her property to Zumman so that he will look after her. The arrangement worked well for a couple of years. Then the situation changed. Zumman and his family were tired of this old relative. Zumman became as indifferent to her as his wife, who grudged even the little food that the old lady wanted every day. She swallowed these insults along with her food for a few months. but patience has its limit. What happened? Now, Juman had an old auntie. She transferred her property to him so that she thought she will take care of her because no one was there. So she has done this, and in that she will get return in caring, love. But what happened after being, means after passing 2 years, couples of year, what happened? The situation got changed. Zuman along with his wife, nature got changed, and they gave that old lady some little food that was really like not up to fill the stomach, okay? And even she got insults also. She got grudged, his wife, Juman's wife, done lots of things, lots of bad words, using bad words. You have seen some kinds of movies also where the youngest one, they just give a nonsense or the very insulting words to their older one, right? So like that also. And she was swallowing, means nigal jati thi sare insult ko ki jo bhi ghar mein hua. She just forget about everything and she left there. But patience has limits, and one day that patience got end. What happened? See, one day she spoke to Juman, "My son, it is now obvious that I am not wanted in your house. Kindly give me a monthly allowance so that I can step up a separate kitchen." Now what happened? She spoke to Juman that things will not go like this. It is very obvious that you don't want to me stay here. Now kindly give me monthly allowance, means mujhe ek month har month tum paisa do, and I will separate my kitchen and I will prepare some food for me and I will eat that. At least that will be very helpful and that will be satisfied to my stomach also and my mind also. Just give me that monthly income and I will separate my kitchen and I will cook my own and I will feed myself. "My wife knows best how to run the house. Be patient," said Juman shamelessly. This made his aunt very angry and she decided to take her case to the village panchayat. You know, long ago, there was no like court, there was no police station. Means police station was there, but the gaon mein jitne bhi rehte the, wo log panchayat, like five people, the head of the village, five intelligent villagers, पांच लोगों को choose करके उन लोगों के साथ वो decision लेते थे आपस में majority में, and the decisions जो भी होते थे everyone has to follow. And what happened? Juman what said कि मेरी wife अच्छे से जानती है घर कैसे चलाना, you don't worry about you old lady. And he said like this, but she hasn't a patience because she lost his all patience, and now she wanted to take her case to the village panchayat where the panchayat will be done, some fair decision would be taken, and I will be free from this tension because it is not good living in a house. She has given her property also, and even after that she doesn't have the respect there. Juman and his wife was not treating, were ill-treating the old woman. For many days, the old lady was seen talking to the villagers, explaining her case and seeking their support. Some sympathized with her, others laughed at her. A few months after, others advised her to. Means what happened? After many days passed, the lady was very in need of that village panchayat. She explained her story to the villagers. The villagers ko pata hai, somewhere like given sympathy to her, ke, okay, fine, this will be happen. Some others laughed at her that how stupid she was to give the property to the any of the person, and others advised ki what she has to do to call the village panchayat, make it up with her nephew and his wife. At last she come to Algu Chaudhary and spoke to him. "You know, Chachi, Juman is my best friend. How can I go against him?" Algu said. Means what happened? He was the village panchayat member, and she reached to him and told all the story. And now she said, she said to Algu that please case प्लीज टेक माई केस एंड प्लीज डू सम फेयर डिसीजंस, राइट? बट अलगू सेड वॉट? अलगू सेड दैट हाउ कैन आई गो अगेंस्ट माई फ्रेंड, ही इज़ माई बेस्ट फ्रेंड, आई कॉन्ट गो अगेंस्ट टू जुम्मन. बट इट इज़ राइट माई सन टू कीप मम एंड नॉट से वॉट यू कंसिडर जस्ट एंड फेयर. टेल मी वॉट शुड आई डू? शुड आई कीप क्वाइट विद दिस लाइक नॉट इक्वालिटी विच इज़ गोइंग ऑन विद मी, विच इज़ लाइक नॉट जस्टिफाइड? शुड आई कीप मम? कम टू द पंचायत एंड स्पीक द ट्रूथ, शी सेड. अलगू डिडंट रिप्लाई बट हर वर्ड्स केप्ट रिंगिंग इन हिज ईयर. नाउ द ओल्ड लेडी टेल हर द ट्रूथ दैट शुड आई कीप मम, प्लीज कम टू द विलेज पंचायत एंड आई वॉन्ट टू टेल द ट्रूथ वॉट इज गोइंग ऑन, राइट? नाउ सी द नेक्स्ट पार्ट. द पंचायत वॉज हेल्ड द सेम इवनिंग अंडर एन ओल्ड बनियान ट्री. जुम्मन स्टूड अप एंड सेड द वॉइस ऑफ द पंच इज द वॉइस ऑफ गॉड. नाउ वट हैपन, द पंचायत वॉज कॉल्ड एंड इट वॉज हेल्ड अंडर द सेम बनियान ट्री. ओके, ओल्ड बनियान ट्री एंड बोथ जुम्मन एंड द ओल्ड लेडी वॉज स्टूड अप एंड दे टू द वॉइस ऑफ द पंच इज द वॉइस ऑफ द गॉड. नाउ दिस वॉज द मीन्स लेट माई आंट नॉमिनेट टू द हेड ऑफ पंच, आई विल अबाइड बाई हर डिसीजन्स. नाउ वॉट हैपन, हाउ जुम्मन सेड दैट कि ये जो वॉइस है पंच का, इट इज़ द वॉइस ऑफ द गॉड, जो पंच डिसाइड करेगी आई विल फॉलो दैट. लेट माई आंट टू बी द नॉमिनेट माई आंट टू बी द हेड ऑफ द पंच एंड आई विल अबाइड बाई हर डिसीजन्स. द पंच नोज neither friend nor enemy. What do you say to Algu Chaudhary? The old lady announced. Now what happened? The old lady said that Panch ko na hi friendship pata hai, na hi enemy. Only the fair decisions lies with the Panch. What do you say, Algu? Will you do fair decision? Fine, replied Jumman, hiding his joy over this unexpected piece of luck. Because Jumman saw, means Jumman thought that he is my friend, Algu is my friend, and he is not going to take any wrong decisions against Jumman. And he was quite sure ki mera friend to aisa kuch bhi nahi karega. And now all the decisions will go against that old lady and will be favor with Jumman. And he was like hiding his unexpected piece of luck and he was smiling. Chachi, you are aware of my friendship with Jumman, said Algu. Now, Chachi, Algu ne kya bola ki, Chachi, you are aware of my friendship na with Jumman? I know that, replied the aunt. But I also know that you will not kill your conscience for the sake of friendship. Now, मुझे पता है कि यू आर द बेस्ट फ्रेंड्स, बट किसी चीज़ गलत के लिए यू आर नॉट गोइंग टू किल द फ्रेंडशिप. मीन्स कुछ गलत करने के लिए यू आर नॉट गोइंग टू किल योर कंसाइन. मीन्स अगर अच्छाई के लिए, मीन्स फ्रेंडशिप के लिए, आप अपने अच्छाई को भूल नहीं सकते. यू आर नॉट गोइंग टू डू समथिंग रॉन्ग विद द डिसीजन ऑफ द पंच, बिकॉज द पंच डिसीजन इज़ द decision of the god, and his voice is the voice of god. And the old lady explained her case. Now god lives in the heart of the punch and his voice is the voice of god, and the old lady explained her case. Now everything started, and the old lady, the aunt of Jumman, explained all the incident what happened with her and told all the case to the punch. Zumman, said Algu, you and I are old friends. Your aunt is as dear to me as you. Now, I am a punch and you and your aunt are equal before me. What have you to say in your defense now? Algu said, look, I am your friend and your aunt is also dear to me because you are dear to me. And don't think that I'm friend, I'm the punch, and tell your things in your defense that what you want to say. Don't consider me as your friend. 3 years ago began Juman. Now Juman started to telling a story. My aunt transferred her property to me. I promised to support her as long as she lived. I have done all I could. There have been a couple of quarrels between my wife and her, but I can't stop it. Now my aunt is claiming a monthly allowance for me. This is not possible. That's all I have to say. Now, in his defense, when Algu asked to Juman ki what you want to say in your defense, he said, yes, 3 years back she transferred and I promised her to support her until she is alive. And now when the quarrel happened between my wife and her, and now she is telling me to give monthly money allowance. This is not possible, and that's all I want to say. Zimman was cross-examined by Algu and others. Then Algu announced, we have gone into the matter carefully, in our opinion. What? Let's see. After he cross-checked karna ki what happened. After listening, before going to any conclusion, we should have to recheck things twice, okay? So recheck karna chahiye. Whenever we are listening to when your friend means, suppose you have two other friends and you, the other one will say you all the story and the other will not come to you. It is our job to know both situation. You have heard the first friend situation, but along with that you should have to listen second one's opinion or the situation or the problem. After that only you should jump into a conclusion. Dono paksh ka aapko sunna chahiye, and then after you are allowed to jump into any conclusion, okay? And this is what happened. In our opinion, Juman, you must have to pay your aunt a monthly allowance or else the property goes back to her. Now, this Algu told to Juman that after knowing all the matter carefully about you and your aunt, we have decided that Juman, you have to pay monthly allowance to the old lady, your aunt. Otherwise, the property which belongs to her, now she will get back the property. Now the property will go back to her. Now the two friends were seldom seen together. They were sad. The bond of friendship between them was broken. In fact, Juman was Algu's enemy and wanted his revenge. Now what happened? Now the two friends who were best friends, जो एक किसी के नहीं होने पे दूसरे का ख्याल रखते थे family का, now all the things got break. Now what happened? Both were separated, both friendship was broken, and in fact Juman wanted to take a revenge from Algu because the decision was not in the favor of Juman and it lies with the aunt, with her aunt, that he has to pay the monthly allowance to her welfare, right? What happened then? Juman was in the shake in the time of sake that he wanted to take a revenge to his friend, not friend, the enemy who became Algu's, right? And now he wanted to take a revenge from Algu, who was friend of once. So this is where I have completed first and second part of this chapter. You can read it by your own also, but this is all about for today. And later when I will come with another video of this chapter, and I will finish all the chapters. So guys, have a nice day to all, and bye everyone.